Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operation Research. This is lecture number 8 in the linear programming problem. We are going to discuss the two-phase method and the problem solving in the two-phase method. In the earlier lecture also, we discussed one problem in the two-phase method. And in this lecture, we continue another problem in two-phase method. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the two-phase method. So, we take the problem number 2 in the two-phase method, solve the problem by the two-phase method, minimize z equal to 2x1 minus 4x2 plus 3x3. Subject to the constraints 5x1 minus 6x2 plus 2x3 greater than or equal to 5, minus x1 plus 3x2 plus 5x3 greater than or equal to 8, 2x1 plus 5x2 minus 4x3 less than or equal to 9, and the variables x1, x2, x3 are greater than or equal to 0. So, in the earlier problem, first problem, we solved maximization type of problem. So, here we are taking a minimization type of problem in the two-phase method. The standard form of the LPP, we convert the problem in the standard form of LPP. So, it is minimization type of problem. First, we take the constraint equation. In the first constraint, we have the symbol greater than or equal to. So, we subtract the surplus variable 5x1 minus 6x2 plus 2x3 minus s1 equal to 5. In the second constraint also, we have to subtract something, surplus variable. So, minus x1 plus 3x2 plus 5x3 minus s2 equal to 8. And third constraint, 2x1 plus 5x2 plus minus 4x3 plus s3 equal to 9. And the variables x1, x2, x3, s1, s2, s3 are greater than or equal to 0. And we introduce the slack and the surplus variable in the objective equation, z equal to 2x1 minus 4x3 plus 3x3 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3. And here, number of variables n equal to 6, number of constraints m equal to 3, number of non-basic variables n minus m equal to 3. So, the non-basic variables are x1, x2, x3. So, set the non-basic variables to 0. So, x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 0 and x3 equal to 0. The result is S1 equal to minus 5, S2 equal to minus 8 and S3 equal to 5, and this violates the non-negative condition of the variables. So, introduce the artificial variables in the constraints R1 and R2. So, in the first two constraints, we have to introduce the artificial variables. Now, the constraints are 5x1 minus 6x2 plus 2x3 minus S1 plus R1 equal to 5 minus x1 plus 3x3 plus 5x3 minus S2 plus R2 equal to 8. 2x1 plus 5x2 minus 4x3 plus s3 equal to 9, and all the variables x1, x2, x3, s1, s2, s3, r1 and r2, they are greater than or equal to 0. Now, number of variables are equal to 8. So, there are 8 variables. Number of constraint equal to 3. The number of non-basic variables n minus m equal to 5, and we fix the non-basic variables as x1, x2, x3, s1 and s2. The non-basic variables are set to 0, x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 0, x3 equal to 0, s1 equal to 0, s2 equal to 0, that yields the result r1 equal to 5, r2 equal to 8 and s3 equal to 9. So, these are all the starting solution for the problem. Now, the phase 1, the objective function is sum of minimize z equal to r1 plus r2, sum of the artificial variables. So, substituting r1 and r2 from the constant equation. So, from here we take the R1 value, from the second constant we take the R2 value, and substituting here R1 plus R2 equal to minus 5 minus 5x1 plus 6x2 minus 2x3 plus s1 plus 8 plus x1 minus 3x2 minus 5x3 plus s2. So, consolidating z plus 4x1 minus 3x2 plus 7x3 minus s1 minus s2 equal to 13. This is the objective equation. And the constraint are the original constraint of the problem, and these are all the constraint of the solution, and this first solution, phase 1 first solution is shown in the table form. So, z row 1, 4, minus 3, 7, minus 1, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 13, R1 row 0, 5, minus 6, 2 minus 1 0 1 0 0 5 R2 row 0 minus 1 3 5 0 minus 1 0 1 0 8 S3 row 0 2 5 minus 4 0 0 0 0 1 9. And this is minimization type of problem. The object is minimization type. So among the non-basic variables, the most positive value is x3. So x3 is the entering variable, and the leaving row by intercept 8 by 5 equal to the negative most least value. So R2 is the leaving row and the pivot number equal to 5. The entering column is x3, leaving row is R2 and the pivot number is 5. We go to the second iteration. So the new pivot row is x3, which is current pivot row R2 divided by pivot number 5. The new z row, current z row minus the entering column coefficient 7 into new pivot row. New R1 row, that is equal to current R1 row minus of 2 into new pivot row. This 2 is entering column coefficient. And new S3 row equal to current S3 row minus of minus 4 into new pivot row. So using these equations, calculating the answers, the answers are shown here in the table, and the z row equal to 1, 5.4, minus 7.2, 0, minus 1, 0.4, 0, minus of 1.4, 0, 1.8, and R1 row 0, 5.4, minus of 7.2, 0, minus 1, 0.4, 1, minus of 0.4, 0, 1.8. And x3 row 0 minus of 0.2 0.6 1 0 minus of 0.2 0 0.2 0 1.6 and s3 row 0 1.2 7.4 0 0 minus of 0.8 0 minus 0.8 1 15.4 and the solution is not optimum. So once again s1 has the most negative value in the z row. So, x1 is now entering variable and the leaving column is R1 because the intercept is lowest value. So, the third iteration entering column is x1 and leaving row is R1 and the pivot number is 5.4. So, we calculate the very other equations. New pivot row x1 equal to old current pivot row R1 minus divided by pivot number 5.4. New z row equal to current z row minus of 5.4 into new pivot row. New x3 row equal to current x3 row minus of minus 0.2 new pivot row. New s3 row equal to current s3 row minus of 1.2 into new pivot row. Using these equations, calculating the third iteration, the solution is given here in the table. Now, z row 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 0, 0. X1 value 0, 1, minus of 1.3, 0, minus of 0.19, 0.07, 0.19, minus of 0.07, 0, 0.33. X3 row 0, 0, 0.33, 1, minus of 0.04, minus of 0.19, 0, 0, 0.04, 0.19, 0, 1.67. And S3 row 0, 0, 9, 0, 0.22, minus 0.89. 0, minus 0.22, 0.89, 115. The solution is optimum for phase 1 because the non-basic variables, the 5 non-basic variables, x1, x2, x3, s1, s2, there is no positive value. So, this is optimum. So, we proceed to the phase number 2. The optimum solution in the phase 1 is used in the sorting solution of the phase 2. So, the constant equations are, so x1 row, x3 row and s3 row. See, x1 minus of 1.33 x2 minus of 0.19 s1 plus 0.07 s2 equal to 0.33. 0.33 x2 plus x3 minus of 0.04 s1 minus of 0.19 s2 equal to 1.67. 9 x2 plus 0.22 s1 minus 0.89 s2 plus s3 equal to 15. And the objective equation is original objective equation, minimize z equal to 2x1 minus 4x2 plus 3x3 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3. And substituting the value here, substitute the values of x1, x3 from the constant equation and simplifying, the objective equation becomes z equal to minus of 2.33x2 plus 0.4s1 plus 0.41s2 plus 0s3 plus 5.67. Rearranging the terms, z plus 2.33 x2 minus 0.48 s1 minus 0.41 s2 plus 0 s3 equal to 5.67. Now the starting solution for the phase 2. So writing the equations, z row 10 2.33 0 minus 0.48 minus 0.41 0 5.67. X1 equal to 0, X1 row 0, 1, minus of 1.33, 0, minus 0.19, 0.07, 0, 0.33, X3 row 0, 0, 0.33, 1, minus of 0.04, minus 0.19, 0, 1.67, and S3 row 0, 0, 9, 0, 0.22, minus 0.89, 1, 15. And among the non-basic variables, it is a minimization type of problem. X2 has got the positive value. So, X2 is the entering variable and the lowest intercept is 15 by 9. So, that is leaving. So, S3 is leaving. So, the fourth iteration, pivot column is X2, pivot row is S3 and pivot number is 9. And calculating the various parameters, new pivot row X2 row equal to current pivot row S3 row plus divided by pivot number. New z row equal to current z row minus of 2.33 into new pivot row. New x1 row equal to current x1 row minus of 1 minus 1.33 into new pivot row. New x3 row equal to current x3 row minus of 0.33 into new pivot row. Using the equation calculating various results. So z row, this is the table shows the result of the fourth iteration. Z row 1000 minus 0.54, minus 0.18, minus 0.26 equal to 1.78. X1 row 0100, minus 0.15, minus 0.06, 0.15, 2.56. And X3 row 0001, minus 0.05, minus 0.15, minus 0.04, 1.1, 1.11. X2 row 0010, 0.02, minus 0.10. 0.11 equal to 1.67. So, it is a minimization type of problem. So, the non-basic variable, there is no positive value of the non-basic variables in the z row. So, the solution is optimum and the result are x1 equal to 2.56, x2 equal to 1.67, x3 equal to 1.11 and z equal to 1.78. So, this is the answer to the problem. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. So, there is one book, Operation Research. You can refer to the book for additional problem in the two-phase method in LPP. And I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. So, thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We will meet again with another video lecture in the Operation Research. Until then, bye.